Hello, everybody.
Welcome to another episode of Basement Electronics. Today, I want to do something a little different. I know that, you know, I've been working on projects lately and, you know, doing a lot of work with Raspberry Pis and Arduino. But today, I want to go over a book review. Now, as an amateur hobbyist, it's really good to try to find some really good resources in order to learn not only the basics, but also some of the more advanced techniques and some of the more advanced information about working with electronics. And I've been seeing this book kind of pop up in my Amazon searches for a little while. And in my last order, I decided to finally just give in and get it. And I'm actually really happy I did. I haven't had a chance to completely read it yet, but the few pieces I have looked at so far have been really impressive. And I just kind of want to go over kind of the book layout and some of the information you can expect from it. Now, this book is from Make Magazine Publishing, and it's written by Charles Platt. It's the second edition, and from what I've read, it is kind of a rewrite from the first edition, and they've kind of improved a lot of the illustrations, as well as kind of cleaned up some of the examples. This is the first book in a series by Charles. The next one is Make More Electronics, and then he also has an electronic component encyclopedia that I think is currently three volumes. And then in those series of books, they talk about various types of components and how they work and how you'd use them. But right now, this is basically the beginning, where a good place to start if you're just learning about electronics. And believe it or not, I am just learning about electronics, and I kind of wish I had picked up this book before I started, because this really would have filled in a lot of the holes. So as I mentioned, there's a lot of really good illustrations. They show you how to hook up various projects. And then just find the index here. So as you can see, the book is kind of split up into various sections, from like basics to, and then they start getting into specifics, such as working with the integrated circuits, learning about maybe some of the more advanced, concepts. And then each section is a number of experiments. And then in each of these experiments, they give a really good kind of description of why you're doing it, the type of parts you're using it, how to read the diagrams. For instance, this experiment actually talks about what a breadboard is, how a breadboard is set up, and why it works. Let's see if you find a. It talks about how the various rows are wired together, and then what your circuit actually looks like wired into the breadboard. And then they go over techniques such as how to cut wires in order to hook up the components on the breadboard. And then of course every component is really well described. And then going through the book, they have perforated boards, shrink wrap, copper alligator clips, and why they're good. And then they even go into, you know, primers like about using soldering irons and, you know, how to solder wires together. And, you know, how to know a good solder joint from a bad solder joint. And also in interspersed, they have like little tidbits of information, like little bits of trivia. For instance, this one here is the wire wrapping in Steve Chamberlain's custom-built retro 8-bit CPU and computer, which really makes, just gives that extra bit of interest. And then what's this? Conversion between, so inch values, so conversion tables. Working with 555 timers. And then towards the back, so you get some of the more complex circuits, and then they also break it down into sections. So you'll notice this here is grade, but they concentrate on this piece of the overall circuit and how that looks in the circuit diagram. Earlier in the book, it actually kind of shows you how to you know, how to kind of match what you see on a breadboard with a circuit diagram. And then where's that last piece? Then they talk about other references and, you know, how to set up your workbench. That's actually not too far off from my setup. And they even go so far, well, they have a section about using Arduinos, installing the program, using the examples. They give you some example programs, as well as some test circuits. And I'm looking for, there we go. Then in one of the appendices here, they actually go through and give you tips about, camera. They give you tips on, you know, shopping online for components, you know, what sort of tools you should be looking for, you know, how to search, what sort of online sites you should be getting your electronics from. Like they have Mouser, they have DigiKey, Newark Element 14, you know, they have, you know, how to communicate with, you know, how to talk to experts. I think they even have one section here. Yeah. Killing autocomplete. No, it's how to turn autocomplete off your Google search to help you find stuff that Google may not realize you're looking for. Like, it really is, like, just from the bits I've read so far, it really is a very complete book. Where was it? There's one last thing I want to show you. There we go. Then also, along with the little bits of trivia in the book, they also have like little biographies of very important scientists, such as Michael Faraday here. And so they add the history, they add the how to, they add the whys, they you know, they describe how to you know, how to read it in a professional manner. And then of course they'll also show you, you know, what happens when it all goes wrong. So this here, they're talking about they put tantalum capacitor in the wrong direction. They fed too much power through it, and it kind of blew up. So, like, really cool information. And I believe there's also a chapter in here where they, you know, what happens when you overpower LEDs. And they even have an experiment where you hook an LED up to a battery. I'm not gonna search for it, but you hook an LED up to a battery and show it's working, and then you touch your soldering iron to it to the point that the LED burns out. And all that is to demonstrate just how sensitive some of these electronic components can be. And I'd never really seen it described in such an elegant way before. Like it just really made sense. So anyone who wants to get a start on electronics, especially if you want to get into like the bare components type electronics, which I do recommend, even if you want to get into Raspberry Pi and Arduino and some of the other boards, you are going to have to interface with these components. And that's what I quickly found out, and that's why I'm doing these videos. But this is a really good primer, and if his other books are as good as these ones, then I'm definitely going to be picking them up too, because there's just so much really good information, and I really, really recommend a good reference and something to help tie it all together. Anyways, and I also want to finish off by saying I am not being sponsored by Charles Platt Make Magazine or any of the publishers or anyone. This is purely my own review, my own take on this. I hope you found this interesting, if not informative, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.